Okay, so I was gonna wait until I was gonna wait until tomorrow to do this, but I don't know. It's like 11 o'clock at night, and I don't really feel like going to bed, so I'm gonna go ahead and knock this out the way now. Okay, so this is just gonna be me giving my thoughts on Hitman Absolution up to now. I haven't beaten the game yet. I'm not even halfway done. I'm up to like I think the fourth mission. I'm on the part where it's called Run for Your Life. If you don't know, that's the I think that's actually the first gameplay footage they released back in E3 of this year. That's currently where I'm at. I haven't gotten past that part yet. So like I said, I'm just gonna give my thoughts on it up to now, and then after I beat it, I'll do another video where I'll talk about what I think of the whole game as it is. So what are my thoughts on the game? It's really, really good. It's really good. I can't say it's great. It's not as good as I thought it was going to be. Now, I don't want to put, I'm not trying to bring everybody's hopes down or anything. I'm just saying it's not amazing, at least not yet. You know, that's the other thing. Keep in mind, I haven't beaten it yet, but as of now, it's not amazing, but it's really good. There's really, really what's holding it back for me, and this is just because I'm a fan. If you're new to the series, this probably won't even bother you. But the only thing that brings it down for me is the fact that it feels very, very different from the other Hitman games. It feels very different. Now, this could be because gameplay didn't really change that much in between two contracts and Blood Money. But for Absolution, they practically rebuilt the gameplay mechanics from the ground up. I mean, a lot of what we all know is still there. You know, you still got the silver ballers, you still got the fiber wire, you know, you still got tons and tons of ways to do the missions and all that stuff. All that's still there. You know, you're still playing as 47 and all that stuff. That's all still there. But the way it's all handled is very different. For instance, sorry about that. But for instance, so anyone who's played Hitman before remembers in the old games you had the map. You know, you could look at the map and you had the little icons that you could use to plan out your strategies and, you know, get your plans going and whatnot. The map isn't in this new one. What they've done is they replaced the map with this thing called Instinct Mode, which, if you've played the Batman Arkham series by Rocksteady Studios, it's kind of like the detective vision mode Batman has in that, except not nearly as useful. That's the thing, is that they replaced the map with something that's not nearly as useful as the map was. Now, I watched a couple of interviews with the developers at IO Interactive, and they said the reason they did this is because they felt like the map was like, they felt like it was like a god mode kind of map. In other words, it made the game too easy. I don't know what they're talking about. I never felt like that made the game easy. I mean, like I said, it just helped you. It made planning your moves and your strategies a little more convenient, but I never felt like it made the game too easy. And the other thing is that in order to use Instinct Mode, because it's not like the map when you can just pull it up whenever. You know, if you get in a jam and you need to see what's going on, pull up the map. But with this, with the Instinct Mode, you have only a limited supply of it. And once it runs out, you're screwed, basically. You have no more. And the other thing is that, you know, like in the past games, you can, you know, steal clothes and disguise yourself and all that. But here's the thing, disguises are not nearly as useful as they were in the older games. And again, it takes Instinct Mode to be able to fool them, to fool the people around you, fool the guards, fool the enemies, and all that stuff. Even though you're wearing your disguise, you have to burn Instinct in order to use that, which means that once all your instincts gone, your disguise is pretty much useless. So all of that is very much a bummer. I mean, for those of you who try to go for Silent Assassin readings like all the time straight through, it's probably not going to bother you because you're not even going to use disguises that much. And on top of that, even if you do, you're going to do it so sparingly that burning a little instinct here and there isn't going to bother you. It won't even matter. But for someone like me who usually does like more of a Panther playthrough where I do use a lot of stealth but I also use a lot of action, that's just how I prefer to play, it can get pretty frustrating. So again, I'm not saying this game's bad. It's not. There is a lot of good, you know, concerning the action. First of all, action has been very much improved. That was one of my main complaints with all the last games, is that the shooting was not very good. Like, you know, everything involving action in the older games was the only thing that wasn't very good. Here, it's kind of the other way around. The stealth is kind of not as good, but the action is really, really good. Like, it's Grand Theft Auto good. Now, I'm not going to talk much about the story because, like I said, I haven't even beaten it yet, so I really can't talk about that. But I do want to talk about the Contracts mode, because I have done quite a bit of this. Contracts mode, as it is cool. It's good, and I like it. But my problem is, it feels very, very experimental. Now, I was kind of anticipating this after I saw what it was, because I'd heard that there was a mode where you could sort of design your own missions and have other people play them online. And I was like, okay, this sounds kind of cool. And when I saw what it was, I was like, okay, this is very cool, this is very ambitious, but I bet it's not going to be all it's cracked up to be. And it's not, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's still really good. Basically what it is they do this play to create sort of thing, where you have to play through the level, mark your targets, kill them, and then you have to challenge other people to do that too, and vice versa. It, like I said, it feels very experimental. I'm hoping that they use this, and the entire game, I guess, I'm hoping they use this as sort of like a blueprint, like they've got this whole, the groundwork laid out, and then when they do the sequel, they can build on it and make it even better. But as it is, it's really good. Not just Contracts mode, the whole game. As it is, it's really good, and I do want to finish it, and I am going to, and like I said, I'll do another video on that later, so. But yeah, as it is, it's good. Not amazing, but really good. So yeah, that's it for this. My next video, I'll probably do one tomorrow, sometime after I get off work. And that's probably going to be, I don't know, that one's probably going to be me talking about the first Metal Gear Solid. It's probably what that one will be. I might do something different, but as of now, I'm thinking that's probably what it's going to be. So, anyway, that's it for this, and I'll see you when I see you.